Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So today in this video I'll be sharing my Accenture interview questions with you. So what are all the questions I have faced in the interview and how will be the interview process and how much time it will take. So I'll share all the details with you. So watch the video from beginning to ending. And I am a 2022 pass out guys. So I got offer letter from Accenture also. So I made a detailed video regarding the whole interview experience and communication round. So I'll give the links in the comments and description. So if you have any doubts regarding the interview experience and regarding communication assessment, you can go and watch the video. So in this video I'll be covering only the interview part, Accenture interview part. So first question that will be in your mind will be whether TR round was there or not. So there is no separate TR round or separate HR round guys, there is only one interview. So in that interview only, based on the interviewer, there may be very few technical questions, not too deep technical questions. So there may be a few questions regarding technologies and projects and some subjects that you have in your academics. So while we attempted this interview, we are not asked to do any coding. Or I saw many other experiences also, nobody mentioned like they will be asking to code. So most probably there will be managerial questions and HR questions only. So let's see my experience here. And the interview for me was around 25 minutes guys, it took around 20 to 25 minutes. And then as usual, initial question was tell me about yourself. So give them a short introduction about yourself. So don't be too long about your intro. Just include the things like from your BTech and where are you from and your projects if any. But don't tell the details right from your schooling. And then he asked about my projects. So he asked like tell me about your academic projects or any minor projects and major projects if you have done. So I have done few projects and I mentioned the same in my resume, and then I gave explanation about them, a brief explanation about each of the project. And then after explaining my projects, he asked what are the technologies that I used in my projects. So one by one each project I explained the technologies that I used. And then he asked to explain about one of my project in detail. He himself picked one project and then he asked to explain it in detail, more detailed way. Then I explained what is that project and what is it regarding, what are the modules that are there in that project and its working. All the things I explained to him. And the next question he asked was, why did you choose this project? So why do you want to make this as your project? So what is your inspiration to do this project, like he asked. And I explained why I chose this project. And then he asked about my role in the project. So he asked, what is your role in the project? I explained it to him. And then he asked, in the project, what are the modules that you implemented? He asked to explain about them. Only the modules which I implemented, like how you implemented and what are all the things you used. I explained everything to him. And then he asked like how many members are there in your team? How many members completed this project? And he asked what are the roles of others? Like how much percentage I completed in this project and how much percentage others completed. And also he asked how long it took to complete the project from beginning to the ending. I explained all those details to him clearly. And then he asked like what are the challenges faced by you in the project. So he asked to explain them, if you faced any challenges, explain them. And as soon as I explained about my challenges, and next question he asked was how you overcame those challenges. So if you faced any challenges, explain them, how you overcame them. And then he asked few like managerial things also, like he asked in case your project was not completed and then the deadline was approaching but your project was not completed, so in this scenario how will you manage then? So I explained him what are all the things I will do in this case if I was there in this scenario. I explained him. And the next question was whom you approached if you have any difficulties in your project. So if you have faced any problems regarding anything or any technology, whom you approached, he asked about that thing. So I explained him. I explained about my guide and my mentor and how we supported each other within the team. And then he asked like if there is any internal clash within your teammates, and then how will you manage this situation? So what will you do and how will you approach them to settle them within your team? So I explained this. And then he asked like if you are in a situation like this, like one of your team members says that I can't do this project and I will drop. So if he said like that, I'll drop in the middle of the project. So what will you do to motivate him, or how will you teach him about this project, and how will you approach him? And then he asked how will you manage this situation. He asked to explain about this thing. And then next question was, so for example, in case you joined the company and you are assigned as a team lead for a particular project, and then there is a particular team member in your project who don't listen to you at all. So he won't be doing the task that you have given, and he won't be listening to you at all. So how will you manage this situation? How will you approach him, and what will you do exactly? So he asked about this question. I explained him how I will handle this situation, how I will approach that team member, and how I will convince him. I explained to him. And then he asked, why did you choose computer science and engineering as your stream? So this is my stream, guys. So he asked regarding that. He may be asking related to your stream then. And then he asked, what is your favorite subjects in all the 4 years, across all the 4 years? And then why it is your favorite subject? And then he asked any contributions to the society, and then how we can use your education to contribute the society. So I explained him this. So if you are any part of the things like helping the society, you can explain to him. And then he asked about my goals and then my hobbies. So simply explain the goals and hobbies, that's it. And finally, there ends my interview. So finally, he asked if I have any queries. So here ends my interview process. So once you observe the interview, so it's a mix of all the questions. Like there are few managerial questions, there are few HR questions, and then not much technical questions. So only related to project stuff. He asked only related to my project, like what are the technologies that I have used. So focus more on the managerial and HR stuff if you are attending the Accenture interview. My friends also had the same experience, not much technical questions. So not a single person was asked to write the code, but there might be few technical questions like favorite language and questions related to that, like Python, lists, tuples, etc. This is for example only. If you are comfortable in C, then there might be questions on that, but very few questions. So that's it about the interview experience, guys, interview questions. So all the best for your interview if you're attending the interview. So do like the video and share it. Subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubts, you can mail me. I'll give the mail ID in description, or mention in the comments, or join the Telegram group. Thanks for watching the video and all the best. And subscribe for more videos regarding all the companies.